जियोबाइट।
हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द जियोबाइट डिप्लोमा सीरीज। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ जेट ऑन फ्लैट वर्टिकल फिक्स्ड प्लेट एंड फ्लैट इंक्लाइंड फिक्स्ड प्लेट। नाउ लेट अस टेक द मूविंग प्लेट टू गेट द डायग्राम। This is the plate, movable plate. This is the movable plate. Movable plate. Assume jet is entering in this direction. The jet is entering with a velocity v. Since the plate is not fixed, the plate can be moved up to this location. Since the plate is not fixed in this case, the plate is moving from its original position to some new position. This may be the final position of the plate. Since the plate is moving with a velocity u, since the plate is also moving with relative velocity u, here the jet is contacting the blade or plate with relative velocity. Relative velocity means like this. If you want to catch the running bus, bus is in front of you, that too the bus is moving. To catch the running bus, you must maintain more velocity than running bus. Then definitely you may catch the bus. But at what velocity you can enter to the bus? You are not entering into the bus by not your velocity or not bus velocity. The velocity with which you are entering to the bus is equal to your velocity minus bus velocity. That is called relative velocity. In the same way, here the jet is entering with a velocity v, plate is moving with a velocity u, then the relative velocity between the jet and plate, let v equal to jet velocity. Jet velocity, which is in meters per second, u equal to plate velocity. Plate velocity is also in meter per second. Then Vr equal to relative velocity. Relative velocity between the jet and plate. This relative velocity between the jet and plate equal to v minus u, where v be the jet velocity, u be the plate velocity. With that relative velocity, the jet can catch the plate. With this velocity, the jet can catch the plate. Then mass of the material or mass of the water entering per second is equal to mass of the water reaching the plate equal to rho a into, you have to take the relative velocity vr, equal to rho into a into relative velocity is v minus u. That is the mass of the water which is entering to the system or plate, mass of the water reaching to the plate with units kg per second. Per second, that much amount of water is reaching to the plate. Then force force acts on the plate. Force acts on the plate. F equal to mass of the material which is acting multiplied by the inlet relative velocity minus outlet relative velocity. So Vr at the entrance minus Vr at the exit, relative velocity at the exit. It is equal to force F equal to mass flow rate equal to what? Rho A V minus U into Vr1 equal to V minus U. Once the jet is hitting the plate in the same velocity, indirectly this is the force along x direction. In the same direction, the water cannot be moving. The water cannot be moving in the x direction after it is hitting the plate. So the final relative velocity equal to zero. Final relative velocity equal to zero. Because once the jet is hitting the plate, there is no further motion in the same direction as that of it is hitting. That means the jet cannot be moving in the x direction after jet is hitting the plate. So it is equal to rho A into V minus U whole square. So this is the formula. This is the formula for deciding, that is the formula for deciding the force acts on the plate along the x direction. Then work done per second. Work done per second. You may have doubt that, sir, in the earlier cases we did not discuss the work done. For the fixed plate condition, work done equal to zero because the blade is not moving away. Though force is acting, since the blade is not moving away, work done is zero. Remember, for all fixed plate conditions, work done equal to zero. So this is equal to force acts on the plate multiplied by distance travelled by the plate per second, that is u. So rho into A into V minus U whole square into U, blade speed U. That is how you can decide the work done per second or power developed by the plate. Now the efficiency, if you want to know the efficiency equal to output by input. Efficiency eta equal to output by input. Here input is maintained by water only. Input is maintained by water. Output means work output. Work done per second. Let me write clearly. Work done divided by kinetic energy. Kinetic energy supplied by jet. Kinetic energy supplied by jet. Kinetic energy supplied by jet. Here work done divided by kinetic energy supplied by jet equal to half into m v square. Here jet, mass of the jet only have to take it. Here the mass of jet equal to rho A V. Mass of jet. For the previous case, mass of the jet reaching to the plate, for that we have taken the relative velocity. But in this case, jet mass equal to rho A V. It is in kg per second. So it is equal to work done equal to what? Work done equal to rho A into V minus U whole square multiplied by U divided by half into rho A V into V square. The denominator value is maintained by the jet only. It is equal to rho A cancelled. 2U into v minus u whole square divided by v cube into 100 for getting in percentage. That is how you can decide the efficiency of the system when the plate is moving, when the vertical plate is moving with a speed u, by the time the jet is entering with a velocity v. Now let us take some problems. Look at the problem. A jet of water impinges on a moving plate with a velocity 35 meter per second. Jet velocity given. Given data. Jet velocity. Jet velocity v equal to 35 meters per second. With this force, the plate moves with a velocity. Plate velocity. Plate velocity u equal to 6 meter per second. If the jet diameter is 9.5 centimeters, jet diameter d equal to 9.5 centimeter. Find the force exerted on the plate, work done, and power. Here force exerted on the plate. Force exerted on the plate F equal to rho A into V minus U whole square. Here A equal to pi by 4 into D square. Pi by 4 into diameter 9.5 centimeters, it is equal to 0.095 meters 1 minute. Diameter equal to 0.095 meters. Then area equal to pi by 4 into d square. Pi by 4 into d, 0.095 whole square. It is equal to 7.08 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. Therefore, force acts on the plate. Density 1000 need not be given. Density of water equal to 1000 kg per meter cube. Here jet is water. 1000 multiplied by 7.2 7.08 into 10 rest minus 3 multiplied by v 35 minus u 6 whole square. Simplify this value for getting around 5954.28 newtons. That is the force acts on the plate. Then what is the work done? Work done per second equal to force multiplied by distance traveled by the plate per second. Force is 5954.28 multiplied by blade speed is given 6 meters per second. You simplify this value for getting 35725.68. The work done is in joule per second. or watt. Watt. So this work done per second is equal to power. Work done per second is equal to power. That power equal to already got it 357.25.68 joule per second or watt. It may be written as 35.725 kilowatts. That is how the problem can be solved. Let us take one more problem. Look at the second problem. A 15 meter per second jet velocity. A 15 meter per second velocity jet of water 5 centimeters in diameter. Given data. Here jet velocity v equal to 15 meters per second. Jet diameter d equal to 5 centimeters 0.05 meters. It is striking perpendicularly a smooth flat plate. Determine the force exerted by the jet on the plate if the plate is at rest. And first case 1, plate is at rest. Plate is at rest. Second case, and if it moves in the direction of the jet with a velocity 5 meter per second. Case 2, plate is moving with a velocity 5 meter per second. Also determine the work done in each case and the efficiency of the jet in the second case. In the second case, you are asked to find the work done per second equal to how much and efficiency. Efficiency eta is how much. This is the problem. Now let us start the problem. Okay, first let us find the area. Area A equal to pi by 4 into d square. Pi by 4 into the jet diameter is 0.05 whole square. Simplify it for getting 1.96 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. Then the case 1. Force on the flat vertical fixed plate. F equal to rho a v square. Rho equal to density of the water 1000. A equal to 1.96 into 10 power minus 3 into jet velocity given 15 meter per second. Jet velocity 15 meter per second. simplify this value, I got 441.78 newtons. That is the force acts on the fixed vertical plate. Case 2, force acts on the flat vertical moving blade or plate, F equal to rho A into V minus U whole square. Rho 1000, A 1.96 into 10 rest minus 3 into V, let us go back to V, V equal to 15, U equal to 5, 15 minus 5 whole square. So you simplify this value for getting 196 newtons. Then what is the work done per second? Work done per second is equal to force multiplied by distance traveled by the plate. Force is 196. Distance traveled by the plate is 5. Simplify this value for getting 980 watts or joule per second. Now come to the efficiency. Efficiency eta, work done by, let me write clearly, work done divided by kinetic energy of jet. The work done equal to rho into A into V minus U whole square into U divided by, here mass equal to rho AV, this is the jet mass, half into MV square. It is equal to rho A into V minus U whole square into U by half into rho AV into V square, rho AV cube. Otherwise, let me write separately, rho AV into V square. Rho A cancelled. It is 2 goes up, 2 V minus U into U divided by V cube. V is given 15 meter per second. U is given 5 meter per second. It is equal to 2 into 15 minus the square. 15 minus 5 whole square into 5 divided by 15 cube multiplied by 100. Simplify this value for getting around 29.7%. Simplify this value. Definitely, you will get more or less the same value. That is about the movable plates. I will give a practice problem for you. Look at the problem. A jet of water moving with a velocity of 25 meter per second. Jet velocity given 25 meter per second strikes normally on a plate. The jet diameter given 60 mm. Determine the force on the plate when the plate is fixed. First case is plate is fixed, and the second case the plate is moving in the direction of the jet with a velocity 5 meter per second. In the second case plate is moving with a velocity u equal to 5 meter per second. This is a easy problem, but this is the one of the board examination problem. It is asked in 2012 Telangana state board examination. you please practice this problem, this kind of problem, almost the similar problem we have done. You try to practice this problem for getting the answers. This is the practice problem. The answers, case 1, case A. For the case A, force is 1767 newtons. Case 2, case B, case B answer is the force equal to 1132 newtons. You practice this problem and verify the answers. Thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we will discuss about the curved plates. In the very next video, we will discuss the curved mobile plates and velocity triangles. That is important concept for understanding the turbine problems easily. Please try to practice minimum 2 times each and every problem, and please subscribe our channel, that is Geopite, and share these videos to all your diploma mechanical and civil students, whoever is practically required. Thank you for watching the video. Have a great day. Geopite.